It literally looked like there were a hurricane coming.
It's Santa Claus.
It's 7 times warmer than it is in Florida right now.
It is actually, yeah.
So we've got a Christmas Eve pop.
Welcome to a new vlog. It's almost Christmas for us. And we've now got to the time of the week which I've not been looking forward to since yesterday. It's time to try and put these hinges on the windows whilst I hold. What are you getting your coat on for?
Because we're taking winter out. It's going to be freezing.
I hold a big double glazed window in my hands.
Big.
In an apartment that isn't on the ground floor while Nick tries to
change the hinge. Let's get on with it.
I'm not even sure I'll be able to vlog this because I need my hands.
You want me to vlog it?
Let you know how it goes.
Come on then.
These are the hinges.
So that one's going to be for this one.
So.
And that one's going to be for that one up there.
Let's do this. So. A couple of hours later, a no dropped window, thank goodness. And it's done.
And a tight seal.
Well, it's worked.
The hinges worked. However, I did need the plastic clips after all as well to pull the frame at the top. The top's not super, but we had to make adaptations.
Much better than it was.
The brackets didn't work, we had to rise them up.
Just another 7 to go in January. Gives us something to do while we're here.
Right, we've packed up and left the apartment for Christmas. Leigh had the bright idea, because my mum asked us to get some quality streets and a sack for the kids' presents and some wrapping paper. And I said, let's go to the range, there'll be less queues. Leigh's just said, there's a Morrison's on the way.
We're a mile from Morrison's.
I'm not sure whether this is the queue for Morrison's or what.
Well, there's no traffic lights there, so...
We'll see when we get there, I suppose.
So yeah, my hinge... it was a bit fiddly to do because the holes on the frame weren't the same holes, but the original holes that were on there had just been screwed in randomly. So we've got some proper UBVC screws, so we've done that, and it's really buttery and smooth now. And we've put the 3 plastic clips in, which pulls the things, and then now when you open the window, you can hear that sound as the seals grab the window frame, can't you? Mm-hmm. And there's literally no draft around it. So that's going to drastically improve the heat performance in the apartment. It's just a shame that I've got another
7
windows to do. But now we know what we're doing.
We've got another 7 windows to do.
Yeah.
I was stood there at some point holding the window.
Yeah.
It was easier than I thought.
It was a lot easier. Yeah. We learned on the first one, it needs risers because the new hinges are quite thin. The old ones are chunky. So it needed risers on it. So we've got all that now. And I just need to order them from Screwfix. We're not even picking them up on way, aren't we?
We'll see.
Phew. That's why we're having to wait. A broken down bus.
So hopefully my bright idea of Morrison's is still going to go ahead.
We've got to get in yet and get served.
Right. Avoided Morrison's like the plague. It literally looked like there were a hurricane coming and everybody had stripped the shelves. There wasn't anything of anything. There was no wrapping paper, no Santa sacks, no quality streets, nothing. It was literally like the shop had been raided. So we're now abandoning the idea of a supermarket. I wonder who thought that one. And we're going to go and try the range, which is more chance of getting less crowds, given the fact that it's 2 days before Christmas. Right, find us the nearest one.
Third time lucky. We stopped at a Lidl, and there was nothing left at all. So we've just stopped at an Aldi. We're just stopping at places on the way past, just in case. All we need is some chocolates and some wrapping paper. So we're fingers crossed. Nick will get it all in here. I've just had to drive around the car park 5 times to find a car park space.
Right, it's a few hours later, we've been with Nick's bum.
Continue on M62 for 43 miles.
Thanks Google, just turn you down. Nick has wrapped lots of presents up for Gail's grandkids, and we had cheese and biscuits for our lunch while we were there. They come round every now and again with like a sweet trolley.
Reminds me of Harry Potter when she does that.
Yeah.
Anything off the trolley? Yeah,
for any of
she
you,
actually says it as well, doesn't she? Does,
yeah. Well, she says anything off the sweet trolley. And we don't usually get out, but I thought, oh, come on, I'm going to have something today because I had lunch and had
is
cheese.
Is that you convincing yourself?
Convincing myself what?
We don't usually get out. Every time she comes around, we get something.
I don't.
You had a coconut and chocolate one.
I don't.
Less than...
Needs to change battery. Battery change, as I was saying. I don't usually get much from the sweet trolley, unlike some. But anyway, I thought I'd have a look today.
You were straight in there with cheese and crackers, though, weren't you?
I noticed they had cheese and crackers, just a small little plate. And I thought, oh, go on then, because we've had no lunch. So anyway, I had cheese and crackers. And then Nick's mum said she wanted everybody to go home. She wanted more friendly visitors, and she wanted a nap.
She was in her right mood today, wasn't she?
So
Because she had a late night last night, yeah, so late night obviously night. she's still going to have the chemo in her system, so she can't do like very active things. Yeah. So
we took her back to her room, got it all cosy. Nick put a Christmas film on for her, got her in the chair, and she's just going to have a snooze for a while.
Until we're fast asleep now.
Yeah, and then probably somebody else will go visit her tonight. So, we are 1 hour 32 minutes away from the lodge. The car is rammed with Christmas presents, which we are dropping off to Santa on the way to the lodge, and he will bring them again on Christmas Day. So, I don't know what we're doing when we get there.
I'm not leaving Santa the wine.
My mum, well, some wine here.
There were two bottles.
My mum, dad, sister, and the girls are already at the lodge. They've been there for a few hours. They've been out for fish and chips. They've been sending photos, making me very jealous. So I don't know. I think we might have a freezer tapas tonight.
I know what's in freezer. Pitters, ice, a couple of cats and nuggets.
Yeah, because my mum and dad have brought all the food over that we bought from Aldi or something a few weeks back.
Yeah.
So they've got to try and ram it in our freezer and whatever's left.
We've got plant-based pigs in blankets, which look like Play-Doh.
We're still not throwing them away.
No, we'll
be having them for tea tonight.
They have been in there a year.
It's Santa Claus.
Hi!
Have you cooked us tea?
No.
Is it all ready for us?
Is Christmas dinner ready?
Hi!
Have you done with some mac and cheese for tea?
No.
You best get on with it then.
Every year we say we're going to make a Yule log and you always say that we're not going to do it.
You've not made that.
Well, yes, just look at this.
You ain't made that.
It's too perfect.
We've put some Cadbury's chocolate on it, it's made it out like a log, and then we put some glitter and stuff on it and then put the little decorations on it.
You might have put the decorations on it, but you ain't made that cake.
No, we haven't made it.
Excuse me, I've tasted Bailey's mousse, and it was Bailey's soup. There's no way that she can make a log like that. Well, not a chance.
We might have bought the log, but then we decorated it. We melted that chocolate, we've put the chocolate on, made it into a bark effect, and then we decorated it with...
You've lost credibility, you've already lied.
No, we did decorate it though.
Set some lights out, let's have a look. Mum's brought some gin from Marks and Sparks, which light up.
Aww! Put it further over in the corner and then we can...
Hey, look.
Oh, look at that, I love it.
It's a shame to drink it,
but we will.
We'll give it a go.
Damn well.
Put some lights on and let's have a look.
You can keep your bottle and then fill it up, can't you?
So Mum's bought some more stuff for the festivities. Shall we open these right now? Okay. Turkey and stuffing from pillages.
Christmas trees.
Why? It's Christmas now, Nick. Christmas trees. Get them open and put them in a
fridge. Oh, no, but...
We can open this.
But I want cheese.
And your thing in your little jumper.
I love that.
I can go with that one. We keep that. Nick's brandy keeps covering that.
Yeah. I love that.
Right, this is the, what's it called?
Baby Yoda.
What's his proper name?
Grogu.
Yeah, Grogu, which we brought back from Florida. But apparently he has a built-in thing when he goes out in the winter. Come here.
Wait, show him how he...
What does he dress like when he goes out in the cold? He has his own little headscarf.
Yeah,
right, we're all cooking sort of bits and bats from the freezer. Tucking curries
freezer
here.
Freezer tapas.
Me and my dad's having tuna steaks, which I bought about 2 years ago, but they're fine. Nick's having katsu curry nuggets with McCain's fries. This is what we're going to have tomorrow. From Aldi, extra large chili chutney sausage roll. Here, Masha, look at this, what we're having tomorrow.
What does it look like? Is it spicy?
Extra large chili chutney sausage roll.
Spicy, no, like spicy.
You got your nails done too.
Do you like spicy?
No.
You're spicy, that's why I don't like it.
I've got something spicy for you.
The chaos has begun as usual. Right, I might have a gin. Masha has been very helpful. What are you doing?
Putting the remaining scents on the tree.
Yeah, so that we've got a nice Christmassy...
We're having a Christmas splurge and we're going to have the last 12 on rather than just 6 at a time.
Yeah.
Because this year they were a bit weak.
We're just having a chat, so we've got Jackson Hole on in the background. It's very snowy.
I've got my help of putting these on the tree. I'm going to put 2 packs on. Just because it's kind of towards the end of Christmas and if we don't use them, they'll just not get used this year.
Eric's been up to no good. He's pinned his little brother into the wine.
fridge and left the kids a note saying ha ha ha. And they've finally gone to bed. I'm knackered from running round after them.
They've been running round the lodge, but Uncle Lee chasing after them.
I'm knackered. I need to go to bed now.
Good night. It's the next day. It's Christmas Eve for us. We're all in Christmas outfits.
Everybody's got some at festival.
Even Nick's got a Christmas jumper on.
What about me?
Yeah, Christmas shirt.
Yeah.
My dad's got
Christmas
on.
Jumpers.
My mum. Christmas jumpers.
My Georgianine.
Still getting ready. She's been getting ready for 4 hours.
Mum, we made an effort. She got anything Christmassy on?
Yeah, she's got a jumper.
It doesn't look very Christmassy outside at the moment. It's sunny.
No.
And blue sky, but that's fine. We're going to head into Beverley. We've got a couple of bits we need to get for the table for Christmas Day, which we have completely forgot about and only remember this morning. And then. Yeah, we're going to go to the Minster because they've got a few services on and things like that. Yeah. Christmas carols.
Yeah.
They might still have all those Christmas trees that were out as well.
No, they don't.
Oh, no, they don't?
They don't let them.
Oh, well, I wonder what they did with all those Christmas trees.
Donated them to charities.
Right, let's go. It's very bright. It's 7 degrees on Christmas Eve, which means it's 7 times warmer than it is in Florida right now.
It is actually, yeah.
Because our friends have been texting this morning saying it's 0 degrees. So there you go. This
Wouldn't it be funny if it actually snowed overnight in Orlando and they got snow?
We didn't.
They've got snow on Christmas Eve and the UK's, well, I've never seen it or never seen it on Christmas Day ever. And bloody Florida, one of the hottest places in the world.
What was I say? Oh yeah, this time last year we were waking up, well not this time, but 5 hours behind, we were waking up in Florida at the Bazzers, and the Bazzers went to Universal for Christmas. And we went out to Panera Bread, I do believe.
And Celebration.
Celebration.
It was baking red hot, and we got my SIM card. Because I was like, I can't do it without my SIM.
It seems like 5 minutes ago.
I know.
And then we went to Hollywood Studios.
No, we didn't. We went to Epcot.
Oh, I thought you said we went to Hollywood Studios on Christmas Eve.
No, Epcot. And we got our annual passes, which run out today.
Right.
So we have 30 days to renew them or let them expire.
So.
You decide.
What?
You decide.
Oh, but I'm expiring. Well. We just can't plan for anything at the moment.
If they expire, we can never have them back again.
I know, but it seems like a giant waste of money if we buy them and then never use them. Obviously, that is a giant waste of money.
Risky take.
Anyway, it's Christmas Eve. We're going to Beverly. The fam want to go into the teepee if it's not too busy, because they've not done it this year. We've done it twice.
Oh, it's rubbish.
It is a bit boring. They need to do something a little bit better. I don't know what they could do better, but...
Well, heating for a start, which we've had in previous years. Actually make the mince pies rather than buy Tesco value ones and sell them for £4
anyway,
each.
That's what they want to do, so we'll go in there. We need to get a couple of things for the Christmas table because, I completely forgot about it with everything that's been going off until Hannah, our friend, takes a picture of her lovely Christmas table that she's setting up today, and we're like, we haven't got anything.
All in pink.
Yeah, she does pink for Christmas. We did blue last year, I believe, didn't we?
And this year we'll be doing it.
Yeah, blue and silver.
What we'll do is...
Although the crackers my sister's bought, oh, I should have showed you them, they're back at the lodge, I'll show you them, are red and white. So they'll be gone on the table.
Goodness sake, does she not know a colour coordinate?
They're whistling Christmas crackers this year. You open each cracker and each person gets a different sized whistle. And then you get a songbook, they're from Asda. You get a songbook and each person takes a turn to blow the whistle and it makes a musical song. So that should be fun tomorrow.
Is it like one of those... what are those things that you used to have?
A recorder?
No, they were like... they were flat with a round hole on the top and you blew into them and it was like a
I don't know.
Oh my god, what's the name of it? A little bit like that, but it was like a little little whistle.
Yeah.
So anyway, you could just hum and the tune will come out the didgeridoo thing.
I know what you mean, but I don't know what they're called.
I don't know what they're called. That's going to bug me now.
The family's behind and let's go to Beverly. Right, we're in Wilco's trying to get some things for the table. I quite like that one.
I do, but it needs to colour coordinate. Masha. Well, we've put some blue balls on it.
Red and silver. Wait a minute, it'll go with the Christmas crackers.
The Christmas crackers are bad enough. We'll have that, that's fine.
Right, we're in Dunelm now. And we were just saying, like, all the people that wait until the last minute to get all the presents, it would stress us out. But there is obviously benefits to it because everything's half price today, all the Christmas
but
stuff.
You run the risk that if you don't get everything and there's nothing left, you're bugged.
I mean... things, look at that. £3 for some, what is it? Cheese, baker and chutney set.
Look at that.
We've got enough cheese set, but mate, it's not bad for £6, is it? I like that.
Pizza knife.
Oh, it's pizza,
with chilli oil, garlic oil and a board to serve it on.
What do you think?
You want one for Christmas?
Right, we've got some bargains so far at Dunelm. We're getting some of these for the table.
which are now 75p. They look a bit chipped, but...
Yeah, well, they do. Charger plates do. All the ones we've got now with the, for the plates on it. But they'll be perfect for, like, putting...
Sprouts.
And things like chestnuts. That. Chestnuts.
We've got two of those stars, which are selling off for £6 each. And we've got the silver napkins.
So what do we use the stars for? We could put the roasters in one,
roasters,
and the
mash,
another.
Yep.
Right,
first snacks time for Christmas Eve. What's this?
It's a Viennese pie. Viennese mince pie.
Oh, no, I do like that. You're going to have to put this cream
with
on it.
With boring cream. Ooh, and we it's not sticking.
Yeah?
Because it's running off because of...
We haven't even got to the TP yet, neither.
I don't want to go to TP. I'm sick of TP. And let the kids have hot chocolate, yeah?
Yes, they need a hot chocolate. We're just in Dunelm Cafe. It's not too bad to say it's Christmas Eve. It's always nice and quiet in Beverley. We need to do Christmassy things after this. Mash just found some mistletoe and gave everybody a kiss.
Where's mine? Where's mine?
You didn't want one. Aww. Right, we're heading across to the Minster, where we should be in for some sort of, yeah, things like that. Christmas things. Right, church done. Why have you got your sunglasses on?
It's just bright.
Just waiting for a car. Let's go. We're going to head into town now where there is a market and my dad really wants a stand pie.
Pork pie to most people.
A big pork pie. Is it just a Yorkshire saying that or what?
Pork pie is not even a... Pork pie is a Yorkshire thing because our friends, Lisa from Cambridge, she's never heard of a pork pie before.
No, isn't it? They've not had pie and peas before.
No, she's not had pork pie because she found it quite revolting that it had jelly in it.
So anyway, it's like a tradition.
I needed a Jadelle as well. She didn't know what a...
It's a tradition around here at Christmas to have a stand pie.
Oh, I can't wait for a slice.
Which is brown basically a massive pork pie that you cut up like a cake.
Why don't you try it?
You like pork pie?
She's starting to be a bit more adventurous with food now. She tried some herby cheese last night and quite liked it.
Yeah, it's
So, stand pie for tea then with brown sauce.
Ooh, lovely.
Why don't you try it? You might like
it. We'll show you when we get it, if we get one. It's Christmas Eve, so there might
Christmas
not be
Eve, guessed. At 2 o'clock in the afternoon. You've got no chance. You'd be lucky if you get party sausages.
We're in Marks and Sparks, and Nick likes the look of this stand pie. It's a bit on the pricey side. It's £16, but it's cranberry topped. And Nick's having a moment.
It's the only one that Marks and Spencer's have got, and everything else is sold out. Yeah, so if we don't get this, we won't be getting one. Look, sod it, I'm just going to get it.
Nice.
It's Christmas.
What have you got here?
Food for Rudolph,
which we're going to put out tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Right, we're at the market now. What's this? A lotus biscoff donut. Ooh. We're in the teepee again, and the heaters are on this time, thank God. We're just stoking up the fire because it's actually starting to go out. Leigh has gone to get me a beer. Are you getting me a beer? That's a yes. And then we're just going to sit here for 10 minutes. The kids are going to have hot chocolates and we're just going to chill by the fire. Teepee done. We're on our way back to the lodge now. Might have a nap when I get back.
I enjoyed that hot chocolate with the flake.
Last time we went, I had a Baileys hot chocolate and it was literally, it had no Baileys in it.
Yeah.
I think it was like a Baileys flavouring last time I went.
Yeah.
But my beer was nice. Nice draft beer.
by the fire.
Yeah, I'm glad we went.
Right,
there.
We're going back to the lodge. Now, might have a nana.
Now for an afternoon and evening of chilling and eating.
Oh, that sounds nice. So we're going to open the stamp pie then?
Well, yeah. And we've got that big sausage roll thing as well.
So stamp pie and sausage roll for dinner with cheese and crackers.
Lots of pigs being consumed tonight.
Yeah, one pig sat inside of me consuming.
Back at the lodge, is that nice, Masha? Mm-hmm. She's eating her Biscoff donut. Need to wipe your mush. These are the crackers that I was telling you about earlier that my sister got. 8 musical whistle crackers. Create your own very mini orchestra with fun Christmas and everyday tunes. So tomorrow we'll all get our own whistle, and then you get like a tune sort of sheet. So we'll all be sat having our own little whistling thing go.
We've been doing Disney trivia.
Have we?
But I'm getting bored.
You're getting bored?
Yeah.
You're getting bored because you want to play Past the Santa.
Yeah, Past the Santa, but you're too busy editing.
I've finished now. I've finished.
Yay.
Right, I'm going to put this in the oven. Extra large chilli chutney sausage roll. Ooh, where is it? Say it's extra large, I can't even feel it. Oh. This doesn't look anything like I thought it would do, but it is uncooked at the moment. Oh, that's not massive. What the heck? It's like half the size of the... that's ridiculous.
That was small.
So we'll put that in to the oven and we're going to have that soon.
Nice. Right, so we're slightly disappointed with that. I mean, it might taste nice, but why just disappointed because the size of it. It's like that big.
How
big is
it?
But as usual, Marks and Sparks never disappoint. So that was the box, and we're thinking it might be a bit small, but it's massive.
A bit small.
Let's have a look. What's inside? Our American viewers will be like, what is this? It looks like a cake.
I can't get into it, hang on.
But it's a pork pie.
I'll do a slice to sort of try and show.
Filled with pork pie and probably a bit of jelly.
I am going
to Oh my God, that looks amazing.
No, that does look
that
nice.
That does look nice. Hey Nick, was just in the bedroom, we didn't see this. So you see the size of that box, Nick? Mm. Come and have a look at the size of it actually when it came out of the box.
It's like a normal sausage roll.
There was like a quarter
Yeah,
of it
but
missing.
It's not cooked yet.
Yeah, but
it might swell up, we'll see. It might swell up.
Wait a minute.
When you stood it at the size of it, like a quarter,
that.
Quarter of it missing.
What a rip off.
I know, I think I got one of them as well.
What's like the stand it? Pie verdict?
Without a doubt, the best pork pie I've ever had.
For 16 quid, it bloody better be.
Oh, no.
Well, look at the food, is it?
Just look at that with all the cranberries on top. You like it, Masha? Mm-hmm. You want a slice of yourself?
Mmm. It is nice.
It might be a bit overpowering for you, might it? We'll cut you a slither.
Even the pastry's lovely as well, isn't it?
Right, I'm going to tuck into mine.
Mm. Right, we're going to play Pass the Santa parcel. So this is full of gifts, is it?
Yeah.
Prizes. Alright, let's have a look.
Is it heavy?
No, not really.
No.
It must be very light gifts.
Right, we're ready to start. Pass the Santa.
Let's go.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Back.
No, I go back. Oh, my mum. What do I take off here? Take his face off.
If you take too long, it music starts again. You've got to keep passing
it on.
It's
the first one, isn't it? It's the first one.
We'll give you a bit longer for the first one, but
let me get his things off.
All right
now.
That
it.
You can't do that.
Imagine it's a toilet roll and you're desperate for a big crap.
Yeah.
Well,
that's it on now.
Massive sheets now.
We've got the closer to the big.
The toilet roll's gone, it's now big sheets.
So yeah, so hang on a minute. Get ready to play the music. Go. Stop.
Oh, should we shake it in?
Yeah, it is.
Little mini Rubik's Cube.
Little Rubik's Cube.
Little
I want to open for some more nuts.
Right, it's time for the Christmas Eve box.
They're not from it.
No, they're just for to randomly eat. Oh, I've got my Skiplings things.
Skiplings?
Skiplings.
You had a bit of a Cali wine.
And it's nice, that Cali wine.
Listen to them scream.
And they will scream as well.
Like, right, we do on most Christmas Eves, we've got a Christmas Eve box.
It didn't for you two girls.
No,
it's
not
grown-ups this year.
Let them open it then.
Right, let's have a flick peek. So
what
see
does it say?
Corner.
What does it say?
What does it say?
Throw down.
There you go. That'll keep you happy for about 5 minutes.
Right, for that, you've got to write a note to Santa, put it on it, and it gets posted back to him magically.
Yeah, don't
now look at these what I've got you.
They don't know what they are.
That's disappointing. I thought they wouldn't know what it was. And that one as well.
It's amazing.
There's a prize for anybody that can put that out and then put it back together again.
Oh, scratch chocolate.
Oh, it's put in your door.
There's one of them. There's one of them in.
Everything's to share.
One of them there with a scratching pen.
And then there's a scratching pen.
Yeah, they've
got
it out.
And then you can make your own baubles.
Make your own baubles tonight as well. No, you can make them tonight and put them on this tree.
Oh, yeah, well.
Stop being such a Christmas Grinch.
Well, back at tree's balls, so.
That's the play, really.
You can put that on Uncle Nick's
you
tree
know what
as
these
well.
Are? You mix them in a cup and put them in a microwave and it makes a cake.
I got a chocolate one.
Within a minute.
I've seen these on TV. Mix.
Right, it's bedtime now.
But look what it says. Yeah.
Right, it's out of the oven. It does look nice. It smells so nice. Small. But it's still small. Smaller than the box was. I'm going to cut it up now and we'll devour it.
Right. Oh, it smells nice. It's slightly large. A bit large, but not as long. Oh, it cuts nice.
I think it's done.
Yeah, it is. It is done, definitely.
Looks nice with the chili jam in the middle. And then after this, we've got some healthy cheese and crackers.
Oh, yeah.
Ready?
Juggling some poo. Ah! As Uncle Nick says, everything's about poo these days. So this is, what's it called?
Drop the pot.
Go on then, show it. Get some plot between your legs.
Okay, so you get a turd in between your legs and then you walk to the toilet and then you need to get it on. Why?
Neither of you did it.
Yeah. After my toilet.
What a pleasant game.
We still can't solve
this. We've all been trying to solve this puzzle for the last hour. Which Uncle Nick bought for the Christmas Eve box.
Yeah.
And none of us can do it. Are you trying to cheat and get the answer?
No, I'm going to look on the vlog on the day we bought it and see what the configuration looked like.
Cheats never beat.
Go on then, I'll have some reindeer poo. Excuse me.
Can I have a reindeer poo?
Do I want one but you get it first?
Is there even any left?
Yeah.
How many? One more.
We've been at this an hour and everybody's been at it. Everything else has stopped and we're on to a 99 pence puzzle.
It's fun. Just goes to show you don't have to spend much to entertain people.
That's it.
Reindeer poo's nice.
Can't do it.
Is it time for bed now? So it's took most of the night for people to solve this. In the end, I had to wind the video back to get the sequence of colours.
Yeah, but Monkey then did it on her own. Man.
She didn't. She asked. She knew that those two pieces and that one was there, and the rest she could solve easy.
But the rest she
What's this? What's this?
For Santa.
And Santa can.
But what does Santa want with a crunchy?
Santa, two chocolates. And a carrot for Rudolph, and then the key to put outside.
So we can get through the door, the magic key. And then you've got a little message for Santa in this tube, haven't you?
Because we don't have a chimney.
Chimney. Right then, best get in bed. Let's put it on the doorstep.
Put it on there.
Right, go on, put it on the doorstep. You can put that out there as well. Well, it'd be brilliant, Santa, if you did that. Right then, let's see what happens in the morning, shall we?
Yay!
Time for bed.
Bye.
Bye.
You ready?
Yeah.
You got your stockings ready?
Yeah.
Or is it hats?
It's hats, because we've got to bring our stockings.
We do have some stockings somewhere, but Uncle has lost them.
Are we going to bring my Baby Yoda one?
Baby Yoda stocking?
Yeah.
You've got your actual Baby Yoda there. Right, you know the rule. The quicker you get to sleep, the quicker he comes. I've just looked on the tracking. He's currently over Ukraine.
Oh, no one's in there.
This has literally been... How many hours? It was a quid, and they haven't left it alone.
Oh, you're very close there, I think.
Oh, no. How do you know the close? Yeah. You've never done it once.
I'm close there.
Go on. Finish it off. No, that cat was there.
Wait a minute.
No. Literally, this is like the third hour. They've both been stood there.
No.
No, there's that square one to go in though, the blue square one. Where's that?
Give it a rest, you've lost.
No.
There, done it. Done it.
Right, they've just done it. Lee's just finished it. Right.
Done it.
Do it again. See if you can do it again now.
Go on, you go.
Oh, it gets boring.
Right, we're bringing presents through. I don't think they're asleep yet, so we're trying to do it as the...
They keep coming out.
We're doing it as quiet as we can. Do we have to do something with that elf as well?
No, he goes
naughty
back on
elf.
He goes back on New Year's from Christmas Eve.
Are you sure?
Santa picks him up.
It's Santa that's left all these presents in the bedroom. We're just helping Santa bring them out. He leaves them.
Just the adult presents.
Yeah, he leaves them because he's got lots of places to go. So he leaves them for us to bring out and put under the tree.
Shh, making noise.
So this is their big present from us.
One of them.
The other one's there. She's got a mobile phone and she's got like LED light system all around the bedroom. This is Masha. It's, what time is it? It feels like 1 in the morning. It's 10:30 at night, so we're going to finish the vlog now.
Because I'm up early in the morning, I'm going to head back towards Leeds Way to an hour and a half to see my mum. She's actually staying at home with my brother tonight outside the hospice, so she's having like a Christmas at home. I'm going to go see her in the morning for maybe 3 or 4 hours, and then I'm going to come back. Lee will have dinner cooked, hopefully. My mum is going to go to one of the stepkids' house for Christmas dinner, and we'll video call her when we open the kids' present. Are you going to wrap them for my mum? Yeah. And then we're going to video call my mum. I'm going to video call these guys with my mum when the kids open her presents, which Lee's about to wrap now, which we got today. So say goodnight. Finish the vlog.
Like button, hit the notification bell, drop something below, and see you on tomorrow's vlog.